I don't know if you've noticed, guys, but in the Oh La La Hollywood Speaks French extract, Soso exclaims at some point, c'est horrible, and Lily says, c'est sûr. Let's stop on that structure for a second. As we've seen it before, c'est means it is or this, that is. When followed by an adjective, like in the examples I've just given you, it allows to make a general comment of appreciation. C'est sûr, that's for sure. C'est horrible, it's horrible. Nothing difficult to understand here, it seems pretty straightforward. But it can get a bit tricky if you're thinking in English and want to translate it's horrible, for example. The problem lies in the fact that it is can be translated into French by c'est, or il est, or elle est. You're following me? C'est, or il est, or elle est can all mean it is in English. So how can you know whether to use c'est or il, elle est? For a general comment of appreciation, you're going to use c'est plus an adjective, as already seen in the video and explained just a minute ago. C'est horrible. The rest of the time, c'est is going to be followed by a noun with an article and an adjective too sometimes, basically by a nominal group. Example, c'est un gâteau. C'est un gâteau. It's a cake. C'est une maison originale. C'est une maison originale. It's an original house. And we use il, elle est whenever we're referring to something specific within the context of a conversation or a situation. For example, we'll say, c'est un gâteau. Il est bon. It's a cake. It's good. C'est une maison originale. Elle est chère. It's an original house. It's expensive. Now I have a little something else to add here. I guess it's kind of an exception. There's always one. If you want to mention someone's profession, use il, elle, directly followed by the noun, the occupation itself. Il est architecte, he's an architect. Elle est professeure, she's a teacher. I'd like to point something out here. In a conversation, you could very well have something like, c'est qui? The person answers, c'est un architecte. As opposed to something like, c'est qui? C'est Bernard, il est architecte. Do you see the difference? In the first option, you give whatever information you know to introduce someone. In the second option, the person's name is given first. We know who we're talking about, so we then indicate the profession and refer to Bernard as il. Make sense? Let's pretend it does and move on to your last exercise. Good work, guys. This is the end of our first block of lessons. Merci beaucoup, bon français, et à bientôt.